Welcome, I am Deepankar. Today I will explain database normalization. Hope you enjoy the lecture. Database normalization is the process of organizing the fields and tables of a relational database to minimize redundancy and dependency. We perform normalization on database to avoid redundancy and associated problems that may occur. Number 1, update anomaly. Suppose Joseph is the new HOD of the math department, and we update the information only in the first row. If one copy of the redundant data is updated, an inconsistency is created unless all the copies are similarly updated. We have missed to update here. So if we retrieve later that who is the HOD of the math department, we will find it is either Joseph or Paul. Okay. So this is update anomaly. Next, insertion anomaly. Suppose we introduce a new department, statistics. We will not be able to insert the record until an employee joins the department. It may not be possible to store some information unless some other key information is stored as well. Next is the deletion anomaly. Suppose Rani retires and we delete this record. We will lose who the HOD is of the physics department. Normalization decomposes a relation into two or more smaller relations like this. Normalization removes the anomalies of the database, but the data that could be retrieved from one relation will require several relations to be joined after normalization. They need to be joined. The higher normal form is cumulative of the lower normal forms. We all know that. The first normal form, or 1NF. A relation is in 1NF if all underlying domains contain atomic values only. There should not be any duplicate rows in the table, and each cell should be single valued. This type of values are not allowed in 1NF. So this is a normal form. All non-key attributes are to be dependent on the key attributes. That is, we have to define what the key attributes are in our relation. Here we have defined the candidate key. These values should be single valued. This is not allowed. This type of comma type values are not allowed. So for Hari, we have discrete math and calculus. And each row should be unique. There should not be any repeating rows. Then the relation satisfies to be in 1NF. (Clears throat) a relation is in 2NF if it is in 1NF and every non-prime attribute is fully dependent on the candidate key. We are giving stress on this word, fully dependent. Okay, and we have to understand what is partial dependencies. We have defined our key in this relation R. This relation is in 1NF but not in 2NF. R has the key attributes, employee and subjects. The key functionally determines the non-key attribute as usual. But we have a functional dependency from subjects to department. It is shown here. And subjects is a proper subset of the candidate key. Okay? A relation R which satisfies 1NF is not in 2NF only if a non-prime attribute is functionally dependent on any proper subset of the composite key in R. That is, department is functionally dependent on a part of the candidate key. So it violates the second normal form. In second normal form, all non-key attributes should be fully dependent on the candidate key. So we decompose the relation in R1 and R2 like this. And this relation is in 2NF. Okay, now if we find a relation where the key is very simple, that is, it is made up of only one attribute, then a relation which is in 1NF will always be in 2NF, since we will not have anything like proper subset. Okay, will not get anything proper subset, it will be the same thing. Now the third normal form, here R, we have taken a relation R. The key is very simple, the course, it consists of only one attribute and the non-key attributes are instructor and room number. Since the key is very simple and it is in 1NF and also in 2NF, the relation satisfies to be in 2NF. But this relation violates the third normal form. So what does the third normal form say? A relation R is in 3NF if R is in 2NF and every non-key attribute of R is non-transitively dependent on each candidate key of R. That is, course functionally determines instructor. Instructor determines room number. So there is a transitive dependency from course to room number. Okay. So this is an example of transitive dependency. So in this case, we have to decompose the relation in R1 and R2. And this decomposed relation will be in 3NF. Right? A relation R which is in 2NF is not in 3NF only if there exists AFD where a non-key attribute functionally determines another non-key attribute in R. Here instructor is a non-key attribute and room number is also a non-key attribute. There exists a functional dependency between a non-key attribute to another non-key attribute. Hence we are having the transitive dependency, which makes R violate the third normal form. Right. A relation is in 3NF only if, whenever a non-trivial functional dependency A determines B holds in R, either A is a candidate key, that means the determinant side is the candidate key, or B is a prime attribute, or the dependent side is the prime attribute. What is a prime attribute? It is a part of a candidate key. Any attribute which are part of a candidate key is the prime attribute. And any attributes which are not a part of any key is a non-prime attribute. Now we are taking this relation R, having the keys student and course. Student and course functionally determines instructor. So the relation is in 2NF and it is also in 3NF. Okay, but it violates BCNF. How? Let us see. A relation is in BCNF if it is in 3NF and every determinant left hand side of a functional dependency is the candidate key. What we said just some time back is, let me go to the previous slide once again, that A is the candidate key, or for every non-trivial functional dependency, whatever the functional dependency, non-trivial functional dependency we have with R, for every dependency, either the left-hand side should be a key or the right-hand side should be a prime attribute, that is a member of a candidate key. But in BCNF, this is not allowed. Okay. BCNF does not allow a non-prime attribute to functionally determine a prime attribute. That means the right-hand side is to be a prime attribute was allowed in 3NF but not in BCNF. See here, instructor functionally determines course. Course is a part of the key. So course is a prime attribute. This was allowed in 3NF, but it is not allowed in BCNF. So a relation which is in 3NF will not be in BCNF only when there exists a functional dependency from a non-key attribute to a prime attribute. So R is decomposed like this, R1 and R2, having R1 having instructor and course and R2 having student and instructor. Note that the common attribute between these two relations, that is, if we make an intersection between these two, R1 intersect R2, we will have instructor which is a candidate key of R1. Okay, either R1 or R2. In this case, it is R1. So we are maintaining the lossless join property. A relation is in 3NF is not in BCNF only when all the following satisfies. There are more than one candidate keys. We have already defined a candidate key here, student and course. There is another candidate key, student and instructor. Okay, these two are also candidate key. That means that with Narayan and Peter, you will be able to determine database. Okay. Student and instructor functionally determines course. So that is also a candidate key, and student and course is also a candidate key. The keys are composite and overlapping. We have already seen here the keys are composite. They're having two or more attributes and overlapping. They have something in common. That is the student. There exists a functional dependency from a non-overlapping attribute of a key to the non-overlapping attribute of the other key. There exists a functional dependency between course and instructor. Okay. I hope you got the point that there exists a functional dependency from instructor to course. See, for instructor there is a tuple with a record Henry, and we also have a record Henry here. Now a functional dependency will be exist when this value and this value will match. Okay, so if I say what is the course for the instructor Peter, we'll say here is Peter and here is Peter, both are same, and it is database. So Peter is the instructor for database. So this is a functional dependency, right? Now we have dealt with functional dependency. Now we'll come with multi-value dependency facts and the fourth normal form. In functional dependency, we had a single value. For example, if I say that there is a functional dependency from student to course, and I ask you the question, what is the course for the student Narayan, you will be able to definitely answer with a single value. Okay, then you can say that it is a functional dependency. But here we can find that Narayan has many courses. One is database and the other is algorithm. Similarly, Smith also takes algorithm and database. Narayan has many hobbies. One is painting and the other is traveling. Okay, so we are having a set values. Instead of a single value, we are having a set of values. So in such cases, this does not violate the BCNF form. This relation is in BCNF. Since we do not have any functional dependency here, right? But Narayan is associated with database and algorithm. Smith is associated with database and algorithm. Olivia is associated with networking. But her hobbies is photography. So we have a set of values from student to hobby and student to course. So in the definition, a relation which is in BCNF is not in 4NF only if there exist two or more independent multivalued facts. Please concentrate on the term independent. This is very important. That means course and hobby are not related to each other. They are independent. They are not related to each other. Okay. So we decompose this relation R into R1. And R2 having student course and the other R2 having student and hobby. This decomposition satisfies to be in 4NF. Now here, 5NF does not differ from 4NF unless there exists a symmetric constraint such as a rule about the correspondence between the attributes in R. Okay, that is the cyclic dependencies. See, Narayan is associated with database and algorithm. Smith is associated with database and algorithm. Narayan is associated with PLSQL and sorting. Smith with Oracle and graph. Okay, now as we did in 4NF, if we decompose this relation into two such relations like we have done in 4NF, what we will get is that much spurious tuples. Let me go to the previous slide to explain a bit more. See, Narayan is associated with database and painting. Narayan is associated with algorithm and traveling. Narayan is associated with traveling and database. Here we are having four tuples here for Narayan. To imply that course and hobby are not related, that means when we are making a join of these two relations, it will be like a Cartesian product. That will be similar to a Cartesian product, and we will not be losing any information. But in 5NF, what is here is we are having multiple projects, but this project is associated with this course. There is a correspondence between these two, course and project. That means Narayan is taking the project on PLSQL for the course database. Narayan is taking the project on sorting for the course algorithm. Smith is taking the project on Oracle for the course database. Smith is taking the project on graph for the course algorithm. So we are having a relation between these two. So to include such information, we need the third table so that we do not lose any information. Okay. Let me go to the definition here. Projection is the process of separating one relation into subrelations, and join is the process of consolidating these subrelations back into one relation. Sometimes this join and projection operation produces spurious tuples because of join dependencies. We get more, not less. The key objective of 5NF is to remove the join dependencies. So we will have this three: R1, R2, and R3. And this is our R. So the relation which is in 4NF, this relation R is in 4NF, but it violates the 5 normal form. To convert it to 5 normal form, we have to decompose R into R1, R2 and R3. I hope this is clear now. CJ date defined the 6th normal form, which requires that the table features no non-trivial join dependencies at all. This implies that a relational variable R of degree n is in 6NF if and only if it is in 5NF and has no key of degree less than n-1. That is, a relation to be in 6NF a relational variable R, which is in 6NF, which have to be in 6NF, we may have at most one simple non-key attribute other than the candidate key itself. Then other than the candidate key, it allows us at most one simple non-key attribute. Now the goals of normalization. Each relation scheme should be in a good form. The decomposition is a lossless joint decomposition. This is very important. Preferably the decomposition is dependency preserving. That is what the functional dependency set we have in R. When we decompose into R1, R2 and up to Rn, we will try to preserve the dependency, functional dependencies in R. Thank you and I hope to see you again in the next lecture. Bye bye.